Good morning. Welcome to This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup. I head content and advice on Magicbricks. I have with me Prabhakar Sinha, real estate editor from the Times of India. We're talking about selling property in today's market. Everybody has been saying this is a buyer's market. A good time for you to buy property if you're an end user, if you have long-term property requirements, this is a good time to buy. What about if you want to sell? Should you hold on to it? Should you sell it anyway? Should you be realistic about the values? And that's what we're discussing today. There are a large number of sellers out there in the market. The last 2 years have been slow. Property buyers have been fewer, and therefore sellers have multiplied in numbers. Prabhakar, welcome to the show. What do you think is the mindset of a seller today?
Now, in this market particularly, if one is selling its property, then this could be for two, three reasons. The number one reason is that he is overstressed and he wants to exit, and he thinks that the property prices are not increasing, but he is keep paying the interest rate on the amount that he has borrowed. So to exit, to cut his loss, so he wants to exit, and so he sells. Number two, those who wants to sell and buy a bigger flat. There are people like that also. And they are the seller, but they are not the distressed seller. Then there are type of a seller who says that, boss, now I have enough. Now I want to invest this money in mutual fund or some other sector because property prices is not moving up. And so I want to exit from this class of asset to move into the some other class of assets. They are also selling in the market. So there are two, three types of the sellers. Now, every seller has its own problem. Now, those who are overstretched and they think that because they can't manage to pay loan, the interest on the amount he has borrowed, in that case, he has to cut loss. And he will have to cut a huge loss today because the market is very bad. And in the secondary market particularly, it is right now going at least 10% lower than the price at which developers are selling. So now the issue is this, and still the developers has an organized market, people directly approach them, and so they have a buyers, class of buyers. But for an individual sellers, the buyers are not many. They have to go to the broker, and a good broker who can negotiate on his behalf to get a good price. But the brokers also, first of all, if you go to a broker, he will straight away say that, hey, boss, if you are thinking that this property should worth 1 crore, he will say that, no, sir, 75 lakhs. That is what the market is going, or 80 lakh at the most. And then after you'll have to wait 3 months, 6 months. You don't know when the buyers are going to come, because I know so many people who are trying to sell property to upgrade the asset, and he is not able to sell it. So for that class, I don't know what to do, but only thing is this, that I believe that arranging finance would be not that easy. That's why he's selling. So he'll have to wait, and he'll have to go to a good brokers, two, three brokers, competing brokers, and try to sell it.
That so Prabhakar, if I've bought a property, say a year ago, and 2-3 years ago, when everyone was buying property as an investment, and I feel that I'm not able to service the loan, or I'm not interested in servicing that loan for such a long period of time.
Now, here are the two things. One is this, that you are not able to service it. Another is this, that you don't want to service it. Then if you don't want to service, then this is not the time to exit.
So you should continue servicing.
You should continue, yeah.
Till the markets lift a little.
Yeah, lift a little, and then you sell it, and then you can make money. Because today, if you are supposed selling at 80 lakh rupees, now after 6 months or 1 year, you might be selling this the same property at 90 lakh of rupees. So you will not be cutting so much of loss. But if you are not able to service the loan, then and say that you had just bought it, it was 2-3 years, so I will continue with this property and I have this much money left, and so I will keep paying my EMI, and then after I exit, and those kind of a buyers are trapped. Right. And because of those buyers only, the prices are not going up, because they keep coming in the market and just they try to sell whatever price they get to exit the market. So for them, this is a very bad time.
Is the average length of stay on the market of a property going up?
Yeah,
How long does it take for a seller to sell a property today?
It all depends on what kind of prices you want to have. Now, if you want to say that the going price, then you might have to wait 3 months to 6 months. Right. But if you want to sell it at a discounted price, then you may be able to sell it in a fortnight or in a month's time.
So it actually depends on how quickly you want the money.
Exactly.
If you feel that you do not want to wait at all, then figure out the locality pricing, put a 10% or 5% discount on it, and you'll be able to exit your property and get your money.
Yeah.
If you are willing to wait for the for another 3 to 6 months, go at the going rate, but never, never put the price above the market.
Yeah,
you're not going to get it.
Because supply is huge. The builders are selling it at the same price. Yeah. So you'll have to put it at discount to the builder's price. Yeah. And the going rate is a discount to the builder's price. And then after you'll have to wait for the buyers, because buyers are very few and the buyers are choosy also. They will think that, boss, why not to buy directly from the developers? Why to buy from the secondary market? Because there is a psychology in the market that buyers, I mean, the buying from the developers directly is a clean property. Right. So if that is the feeling in the market generally, no, there is nothing like that clean or not clean property. Even if one is buying in the secondary market, it is as clean as you are buying it from the developers directly. But I mean, generally, if you talk to the buyers, normal buyers, they'll say that, no, boss, I want to do a deal with developer directly.
Right.
So buyers from the developers are much larger in number than that is from the individual sellers.
And this is actually a change from what we've seen on Magicbricks some time ago, where people wanted to buy from the individual sellers because you were getting a better deal.
Yeah.
Today, developers are giving very good deals.
Exactly. Now, in fact, it is the asking price. Now, the developers are ready to sell it at the asking price. They are saying that, okay, but what is the price you want to pay?
Right.
And then on that, they will negotiate.
Right.
Many of the developers are not quoting their own price. They say that, okay, you tell me your price, what price you want to buy.
So if there are any buyers out there listening to us, this is a good strategy for you. Look at the average market price and then go with the realistic pricing. Maybe you can bring it down a little, because all the negotiation is going to be around what your asking price is, and that asking price is very important. Prabhakar, let's talk about developers as a body of sellers who have a lot of stock, much more stock than they've ever had, ready built stock, ready to occupy. What is their strategy? Take us through that different types of developers.
Now, there are two, three type of developers here again. Those developers who need to have money immediately to service their loan or service their other liabilities. Now, those kind of a developers, and they are not able to reach funds from other sources. Banks are not ready to give them private equity, not ready to invest in their project, suppose. So those kind of buyers, sellers, developers are very, very stressed. And there, one developer was telling me that, boss, there the price is what you are quoting, the buyers are quoting. And there they are saying that, but I mean, he is quite a decent developer. He says that, but you should not take that as the market price. That is not the market price. Now, in Noida, Greater Noida Expressway itself, you can get a good ready-to-move-in property for 4,500 rupees per square feet in a decent, good locality and a good flat, very good flat, which was earlier quoting at 6,000 rupees per square feet. So this is the kind of a situation there, because that developer is a bit distressed. Now, many of these developers are selling it to the financiers also.
Uh-huh.
Now, there are big financiers in the market, and these financiers, because that developer needs 5 crores of rupees and he has a lot of inventory. So he just sell him 15 or 20 flats, apartments for 5 crores of rupees. Now, there the discount goes up to 30%.
Uh-huh.
Now, these financiers sells in the market at a hugely discounted price because they want to make a fast buck.
Yeah.
But because of this, the developer's other stocks, the valuation also goes down, but the developer is forced. I mean, they have no choice.
Right.
So that is why they are indulging into this kind of situation. But this is also happening, particularly in the last 3 months, this has started happening. And some developers are there, which are very good developers, very respected developers. I mean, they fix the price, that was, this is the price. They are not stressed. They are saying that, boss, no, I am not in hurry to sell. I have money. If I'll be able to sell it, fine, I'll be able to sell it. And I have money to continue the construction, finish the construction. So I'm not selling it like that. So those developers are good developers. So now if you want to buy, say, in any area, Noida, Greater Noida, or Gurgaon, or any of these areas, and if you want to buy your flat in that project, in that with that developers, because his after sales servicing or maintenance, other things are very good, then you will have to pay premium because they are not discounting the price of their flat.
So let's try and understand. There is one developer who needs the money, who's discounting and who's selling off his property.
Yeah.
There's another developer who has brand value, who builds meticulously builds good property. As a buyer, whom does the buyer go to first?
No, I believe that here in this case, if a project is completed and the developer is decent, then you can go for that buyers and you can buy it from that developer directly rather than going with the prestigious or A-class developer and who is quoting say 30% or 35% say in Noida, Greater Noida Expressway, some developers are selling it 4,500 and some developers are selling it 6,500 rupees per square feet. Now this developer's flat is also the same. I mean, the locality is the same. Maintenance also could be same because...
Does the gentry differ? Who's my neighbor? Does that matter?
Yeah,
so certainly,
that is the class developers. If the A1 class developers will have a better gentry because the normally that is developed as an address. And so you will have a better gentry. And for that, they are charging the premium of 10% to 15% premium can be given, but not 30% premium.
That's right.
Now, if he is asking, but because today, because of the market dynamics, now that gentleman says that I can't discount my price below this.
Right.
Okay. But this developer is selling it not at the market price, at a discounted price because he's stressed.
Right.
So the gap is huge. Now, so now it is up to you that what you would like to do. Now, I believe that over a period of time, long term, 5 to 10 years of the time, normally the gentry also evolves. No, from what happens that if in the neighborhood one flat is selling at a very high premium, then suddenly the price will start going up or the, some better people come and buy them out and start moving in. And so it's a harmonized, totally homogeneous kind of environment develops. But certainly it takes time. And normally, I mean, some may differ from this also. They say that this doesn't happen. But I don't think so because I have seen in some of the locality, once upon a time it was very inferior gentry, but some time after it improves also and the quality becomes almost the same. So here I believe that it is up to negotiation, number one. Number two, availability of the flat. Now, if it is completed, but find out the developers. Now, developers should be decent one. It's not that the developers should be third rate altogether.
See, there are a few things I think we should keep in mind. One is that is the quality of construction perfect? If whether you're a big developer or a small developer, ultimately for a consumer, is the quality of construction good? The second thing that is
ready to move in.
Is it ready to move in? Can you just buy the property and move in with minimum hassles? The third thing is that if the developer is giving you any freebies, do those freebies matter to you? If it's a modular kitchen, it matters to you. That reduces the pain that you have to take to fit out your kitchens, your cupboards, and so on. But if the developer is giving you something peripheral, which doesn't matter, a gold coin or something like that, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And I think you should negotiate for good
but
credit.
Discounts. Many a developer, I have seen a developer, we thought that he will be quoting 5,500 rupees. When we went there, he quoted 5,000 rupees just straight away.
Right.
We were surprised. When we bit off son that, no, this is a bit higher, he said 4,800 rupees.
Right.
Then we talked to somebody else, he said that, you will get it 4,500 rupees.
Right.
Then we came in touch of a financier and he said that was 4,500 rupees. Will you buy it?
Right.
And we bought it at 4,500. So this is the kind of, and that developer, mind it, is a very good developer. He's
right.
A hotelier.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he's known to develop or maintain that apartment very well. So there's no point in going for the A1 grade of the developer instead of this developer also, because the price difference is huge.
Right. Remember that if you are an individual seller in this market, developers are throwing in freebies, developers are discounting wildly, the financiers are discounting significantly. In this market, if I have a property to sell, let's talk about how I can get the best value for my property.
Now, look, number one, if you want to just upgrade, then what I'll suggest you that don't sell it right away. Because there are lot many developers who are selling it today, saying it ki boss, okay, you pay 20% today, and then after you pay after the completion of the project. Okay. So what you do that you try to find out in some mechanism where you just continue with your existing flat for 6 months or 1 year, whatever the time, because this is not the time to buy, and this is the rock bottom price. Let me tell you this. Right. So prices are going to appreciate from here only. And if you want to upgrade, you buy that flat, pay that 20% amount, and try to continue with this property for some time, keeping in mind and ask some broker that, okay, boss, the moment the price goes this much, I want to exit, you sell this project.
Right. And fix then an exit price. Actually, what Prabhakar is saying is a very significant thing. You fix an exit price. Below this price, I'm not going to sell.
And then you can upgrade also.
And you can also upgrade because there are bigger properties available to you.
Exactly.
And it is available at a lower price. So be a sensible seller. If you are not in immense need of that money, you can either upgrade or you can, the second thing that you can do is fix an exit price and tell a broker, tell some of the sellers that you will not go below this price.
Yeah.
And then wait for the right price. There are a few sellers, Prabhakar, who are also throwing in furnishings. For instance, your ACs, your microwaves, your gadgets. Does it help to invest in these to get a better value?
No, because the buyer will normally, if a buyer is buying a house for 1 crore, then he will certainly not go for the second hand AC, even if it is 10 days old. Uh-huh. He will certainly say, give us no, I want to change it. Okay. In fact, if one has occupied a house, then the new buyer will change everything, the bathroom fittings, everything, he will change it according to his own taste or according to his own likings. So, and that is what the discounted, basically the discounting they are asking for. So investing now, if you have bought it to sell it only, then don't invest in it at all in the furnishing, because the new buyer is going to invest again some fresh money in that to have that entire thing decked up according to his own choice.
Sure.
So now, basically you should not, that will be the loss.
That will be a loss for you, and you would have spent money furnishing it and not get enough returns out of it. Okay. Let's quickly pick up some of the queries that have started coming in. I had bought a 2 BHK and IP extension for 80 lakhs 6 years ago. I want to sell it for close to a crore and upgrade, but I'm not getting any buyers. What should I do? I think one, become more realistic. You're not going to get 1 crore. Whatever you get, you'll have to top up. If you want to buy a new property, you'll have to top up with another loan.
Yeah,
right?
No, IP extension, I mean, 2-bedroom flat can go in 80 lakhs around, or 75, 80 lakhs rupees still. And for that money, one can buy easily 3-bedroom flat in the Noida, Greater Noida Expressway, or in Gurgaon also, in any of the area. But if she wants to wait to sell it at 1 crore, then I don't think that will be very wise to wait also for,
right,
because
this fresh stock coming into the market constantly, and fresh stock is new, modern, more loaded with facilities, and she may not get more up to 1
and
crore.
IP extension, Delhi area, the price is not that much depressed. Of course it is depressed, but not that much.
Yeah. So I think you will be able to get only about 80 lakhs for your 2 BHK and IP extension.
Around that, yeah.
Check out with a few developers, but I don't, a few brokers, but I don't think you will get what you're expecting. I think your expectation, you have to rationalize. Let's go to the second question. What happens to my home loan if I'm selling my property on which I have 20 lakh loan pending?
Now, certainly what happens that, I mean, if she has taken loan against that property, that means that the paper of that property will be with the banks only. Yeah. So now suppose she sells this property, say for 50 lakhs of rupees. So out of that 50 lakh of rupees, first that 20 lakh rupees will go to the bank and that loan will be settled, paper will come to her, and then only the buyer will get the paper, and the this entire transaction will go will happen in the three way. And so there is no issue in this because everybody has taken loan and while selling their property, the banks are involved in that case and banks cooperate also in that case.
Right. Banks, to a bank, it doesn't matter whether you are the owner or the new buyer is the owner. The bank is only bothered about the
his money
and the servicing of that money. As soon as you sell, the you first have to clear the bank's loan, get
then
your papers
the paper
back.
Will, yeah, and then she can deliver the paper to the buyer.
And if it is between two banks, then the banks work among themselves to settle this. If the buyer is taking a loan from another bank, you have to put the two banks together. They settle the issue and you get the rest of the money.
This is not a problem at all.
Yeah. Why are some properties cheaper in resale than fresh properties? I think you just mentioned it. Resale is cheaper because the builder is already lowering prices and selling. So when you're buying from individuals, the individuals who want to exit today in a hurry, they will try to give you sweeten the deal by offering lower prices.
Otherwise, people normally prefer to buy directly from the developer. Right. So certainly the prices of the property with the developer is higher than the in the secondary market.
Right. There's Lokesh from Noida who says he's living in a rental house and wants to buy a property. Should I continue living in a rental home or buy my own property? What is more profitable in the long term? This is while we are discussing selling today. I think we will actually address.
No, this is a good question.
Yes.
Now the issue is this, that how does he plan to buy it? Now suppose today if he is paying 30,000 rupees rent, that means he can borrow around 40 lakh of rupees.
Yes.
Or 45 lakh of rupees. With that money, he can buy a two-bedroom flat. But with 30,000 rupees rent, he would be living in a three-bedroom apartment.
Right.
So that means he'll have to compromise in the space and also on the location. 30,000 rupees, he can live in the Mayurbhia.
Yeah.
But with 45 lakh rupees, two-bedroom flat, he'll have to go into the Noida or Greater Noida side.
Yes.
So he'll have to compromise on the distance. So what
or you have to top it up and say that I pay 30,000 rupees rent, but if I put another 10,000, I will be able to service a EMI of 40,000 and eventually own the property.
Yeah, of 55, 60 lakh of rupees.
Right.
So then he can think of buying a two-bedroom flat in Noida or three-bedroom flat in Greater Noida.
Right.
So again, he'll have to think of that. I mean, what he should do? Should he travel more and he will not compromise in the space? Or he will travel less and he'll compromise on the space.
Right.
So this is the give and take he'll have to think of and he'll have to decide.
See, today people are able to think like this because the markets are depressed and the cost of property has come down significantly. Remember that when you're paying for a property, you'll be paying over a long period of time, right? About 15 or 20 years. In that period, if you continue to pay rent, it's an outflow from your end and you will have no asset in your name. The advantage is that you are building an asset and at some point of time that asset could come in handy.
Yeah, so in this market I believe he should buy a house and shift because that will become also a forced savings. Plus, he will have an asset which he can sell after some time when the market is good and can move on to a bigger flat.
Absolutely. So, actually you are building a long-term asset which whose value can only go up. The value of that asset is not going to come down because today prices are at rock bottom. There is Komal Singh from Delhi who says, how do I find the seller to buy a resale property? What is the best way to negotiate on prices? I'm searching in Noida and sellers are not ready to reduce the price.
You should talk to the broker.
You need a specialist. No doubt about it. While a lot of people are apprehensive about going to a broker, the best way to find the right broker or agent who will help you through this is to find somebody with a recommendation. If a broker has serviced another seller and that seller recommends that he works well, please use those brokers because today there is no rating of of brokers. So you would have to go with word of mouth and by referrals.
But I don't think, I mean, today you call a broker and broker will tell you that what is your range in which you want to buy. And then they will offer 10 of the property. Now you'll have to choose.
Right.
Now it is up to you how to negotiate with the broker and with the seller.
Right.
And you can arrive at a good price.
Right.
So it's not that today that the flats are not available or buyers are not reducing the price. Certainly, if you're going to buy a property, say, worth sometime 1.5 crore and today it is quoting at 1.2 crores. Now you tell him that, no, sell it at 80 lakhs of rupees. Okay. Certainly, they will not sell it at 80 lakhs of rupees. Right. So it's all up to the, I mean, in the realm of the negotiation and your the price quotation.
See, the broker knows that, has his ear to the ground. The broker knows the reality on the ground. Before you start your dialogue with a broker, you must also do your research and find out what is the benchmark pricing in that locality.
Exactly.
Just because it was 2 crore
and quoted. Yeah.
Just because it was 2 crore a year ago and you still are quoting 2 crore, figure out what the last sale was. And that is not so difficult in today's market. Yeah. You ask around, there are sales happening. Ask what the last sale was and your price should be very similar to that
exactly.
last sale. That's how you have to negotiate. The brokers will your first negotiation is with your broker to fix a selling price that I will not go below this. You are fixing the selling price from your end. After that, you have to figure out how much the buyer is willing to pay, and you may have to negotiate.
And if you are a buyer, then you'll have to fix your price that, okay, I'll have to pay this, and then negotiate. Yeah. And don't just look for one property, look for 10 property, and then you think that which one, I mean, okay, best location, best property that right. you are liking, I mean, that you might have to pay the price for that also. So accordingly you decide. But it's saying this, that property that sellers are not cutting the price, I mean, obviously, I mean, they would have already cut the price below which
absolutely.
They might not be able to do that.
And as a seller, remember that he has paid a certain amount to buy the house. He's serviced a loan over a period of time and he may not want to take a
yeah, it's up to
loss.
Her to negotiate. I yeah. mean, the prices are always there and you can find a good thing in that price.
Let's go on to a query by Sarit from Gurgaon, who says his budget is 80 to 90 lakh and he's searching in Gurgaon, preferably near an established locality. What can he get in this budget? He has seen some projects but the rates were too high there, and can he get a 2 or 3 BHK resale flat at a good location in Gurgaon?
Now, in Gurgaon, there are many areas with this kind of a price, 80 to 90 lakh of rupees, certainly not on the Gulf Coast Road, but if he wants to go to New Gurgaon on the one hand, or the Dwarka Expressway on the other. I believe that in those areas one can.
In Dwarka Expressway, you'll get a lot of properties in this range. There are all ranges of property along the Dwarka Expressway. Towards Sona, that is south of Gurgaon, you will be able to get properties in this budget. There are some properties along the Sona Road, but I think that will be a little over your 80 to 90 lakh budget. Remember, Gurgaon is a very expensive town. Gurgaon has traditionally been the most expensive market in the NCR because the sizes of the properties in Gurgaon are very high because of the density norms. As a result, what you buy in Gurgaon will definitely be a larger size. You can also look at some of the affordable housing projects. Some of the projects here are good projects. The sizes may have shrunk, but the projects are well executed. You may want to scout around in the market. Don't lose heart. I think there are plenty of properties for you to look at. Go to Magicbricks, put your budget, put your requirement. You'll get a drop down of all the properties that are available. Now, out of those, you start isolating those localities that you want to stay in. Then go and check out the prices. I think that you will find a property to buy. Let's look at Dinesh from Noida. He has a 3 BHK flat in Greater Noida and has recently got possession. He wants to sell this off and buy an independent house in the sectors. Is it possible for me to do that? How much extra money would I be needing for this? Dinesh, I think this is a very good time. If you're looking at an independent house in the sectors, this is a great time for you to look. There are two reasons for this. One is that you may not get the best price in Greater Noida, but because there is a lot of property, ready stock available there, but there are a lot of consumers looking for property, so selling may not be an issue if your price is right. And also remember that there are a lot of sellers in the plotted developments who are looking to sell off their units, and they are far more rational in their prices. In I would take the example of sector 26, 27, where a property that you were getting at a piece of land of about 164 square meters, you were getting at about 3.5 crore a few years ago. Today, the sellers are willing to negotiate at 2 to 2.25 crore. That means it's a whole crore less than the peak value. And you may be able to still negotiate good rates and get a plot depending on the sizes that you want. Yeah. This is a good time to do this. Let's take Komal from Delhi, who has a builder flow apartment in West Delhi. The location is not that great and I want to buy a society flat in Noida. I'm getting 50 lakh for my flat. Will I be able to buy a 3 BHK in Noida?
Not in this amount. So you'll have to increase a bit at around 70.
So what you need to do is sell your at the 50 that you're getting, top it up with a loan. Banks are quite happy to give you a loan if you're a serious buyer, and top it up and don't compromise on where you want to buy or the kind of property you want to buy. Top it up and take a little loan and
then move in for 65-70 lakhs, you can get 3-bedroom flat.
And it's not a bad deal because in Noida, some of the apartments that you're getting are good quality apartments. But do check out the quality, do check out the developer and the locality before you buy your select your flat, because Noida has a huge amount of stock and plenty of choices.
So you will have to do a legwork to find a flat of 3-bedroom for 70 lakhs of rupees.
That's right. Remember, there is no substitute to legwork, site visits, talking to people who have bought with that developer to figure out whether they're happy living in those apartments. Nisha Verma, Faridabad, is this the right time to sell a property as the market is down and it is difficult getting a prospective buyer?
No, it's not the right time to sell. Certainly.
Faridabad is not selling. You have a problem there. You'll have to wait for the markets to become a little more buoyant.
Yeah.
Where can I find resale property details online? I want to search in Gurgaon within 40 to 45 lakh budget. How do I approach a seller? First of all, the sellers are on Magicbricks. Come to Magicbricks, put your requirements, your budget, your requirements, and you'll get a string of properties. And that's how you can...
She will get it in the affordable housings. Nowadays, a lot many projects are coming up in the affordable housing, and there she can get in for the 45 lakhs 2-bedroom flats.
Right. And some of the 2-bedrooms are go for the developer who builds well, who's serious about affordable housing and not just pushing the concept.
Exactly.
Right. Mahesh of Greater Noida wants to sell off the flat and not able to find a buyer. Has a 3 BHK in Noida extension with a size of 1400 square feet. Wants to sell it at 70 lakh. Is that the right price, Prabhakar?
Yeah, 70 lakh is fine. I mean, that is the price he should get. But only thing is this, that this is not the time to, sell, particularly the Noida extension, Greater Noida, because there the supply is huge. So he'll have to wait. I believe he'll have to keep trying. And even if he will reduce the price in Noida extension, 70 lakh.
It's a little higher. You will
have 65
is a much better price here. This is a problem that's cropping up on our discussion every week, I think. I want to buy a property in Noida, Greater Noida, but properties are being sold with TM charges, which are about 300 to 400 per square foot on property, which is high and making buying and selling difficult in the secondary market.
Yeah.
How can these charges come down?
Yeah.
Prabhakar, please explain TM charges and will they come down?
Yeah, no, basically this is the charge which authority takes, and developers only collects it, or the sellers only collects it, and the developers only collect it and deposit it with the authority. So basically this is not a developer charge, so the chances of its reducing is not there. Of course, this is a bad charge, I believe, and very high charge, and this makes the market rigid, because to have a liquid market, such charges and such penalty over the sale and purchase should not be there, which is like this. Mm-hmm. Besides a stamp duty, they are charging this 300 rupees per square feet,
which is rather
very high.
Yeah.
And but unfortunately, this is how the market is today, 400 rupees per square feet, and one will have to pay it.
And if you are looking to buy in Noida, Greater Noida, we don't see that coming down. It hasn't become a contentious issue that various forums are picking up and fighting again.
But
so this is there for a while at least. What happens to my home loan if I'm selling? I think we've taken that query. Karan of Gurgaon says, which is the best location to search for resale property, a 2 BHK between Noida and Gurgaon within a 50 lakh budget?
Within 50 lakh, Noida.
Noida. You yeah. can't get a 50 lakh property in the Gurgaon market.
In Gurgaon, affordable segments only. Affordable housings launched by some of the developers. In that, he might get this property.
That's right.
And he should try there directly.
Right. And the Haryana affordable housing norms are very well established.
Yeah.
A lot of developers are building there. And those projects, are the prices are going to be held at, capped at 4,000 rupees for yeah. until a year after possession is given.
Yeah.
And I think...
So that the price sometimes is around 30 lakhs or 35 lakhs, right. like that. But that is very good. 2 BHK house in yeah. 600 square feet carpet area. Or 800 to 900 square feet built-up area. That's a very good size of the flat, and one can get it easily. One should apply, because nowadays not many applications are coming, though it is so sold through the lottery and all that. Yeah. But one, the chances of getting the flat in that is very high, and one should try in that one.
Right, and this is the this is part of the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, where the government is trying to figure out that every first buyer should find a property that is affordable to him. This is the affordable yeah. housing scheme promoted by the government of India. Also, remember, we have had previous shows on this. You are entitled to a credit linked subsidy scheme on these houses, and if you have a salary of 6, 9, 12 or 18 lakh, you can get varying
up to
levels.
2.40 lakhs rupees subsidies.
And that will bring down your monthly EMI by about 2000 to 2200 rupees yeah. for the a tenure of about 20 years. There's Shyam Talukdar from Mumbai. I have plans to buy a shop in Thane, but I'm a little confused on giving it on lease. Actually scared that the tenant may possess my property. What are the laws on these, and are they in my favor? First of all, Shyam, at this point of time, we feel that small retail buyers should stick to residential properties. Investment in commercial properties, remember, if you give it to a establishment, the establishment has a support structure to fight a legal battle with you. You are an individual and you may not be able to take that on. And your fears are justified.
Yeah.
We've also been writing on content.magicbricks.com that there are two things that you should look at: the leave and license format, which is the norm in the Mumbai market. That is safer for you than, of course, the lease format that is prevalent elsewhere in the country. However, as retail buyers, I still feel that commercial property is a risky
yeah.
investment proposition. Srishti Shoran from Bhiwadi had invested in a flat in M3M Woodshire in Gurgaon. There is no appreciation there. What should I do? Hang on to your property. You're mm-hmm. talking about something that's on the Dwarka Expressway. Remember, the expressway has been mired in problems for many, many, many years. Prabhakar, a quick update. What is happening on the Dwarka Expressway?
Basically, now the government has declared this Dwarka Expressway as NH, National Highway 8A. And now they have already started the process of acquiring land towards Delhi to complete the highway. And plus those who have to, displaced from there to acquire some of the property in Haryana side, that process is also on. The court has already ordered. But it is taking time. Now, every time if you talk to the authority, they say that in the next 3 months it is going to be done. So I don't know when that next 3 months will complete. But I hope that the road will be, up and running soon.
Yeah.
And so the Dwarka Expressway is taking some time, and that is why today the price is at hugely discounted level. Once the road is complete and the power and the water supply is put in place, the property prices will go up. Now, those who have a flat there and who wants to sell it just to buy somewhere else should not do that. Because Dwarka Expressway itself is the best locality to buy property today, to my view. So one should not sell it just for that. But if the reason is something else, then I don't. There is no.
If you bought Woodshire when it was launched and you're holding on to that property for so long, this is a bad time to exit that property.
Yeah.
Because once the Dwarka Expressway is complete, you will find that the prices will go up. And property markets have been depressed for the last 2.5-3 years. And today we see a large number of end users already actively looking for property, this can, the tide is expected to change.
Right? Yeah, yeah. At the moment that this entire expressway is up and running and the water supply, everything is put in place, the prices in Dwarka Expressway will shoot up. I can't put a figure that, okay, by how much in 1 year, but this is the lowest level of the price because all those infrastructure is bound to complete. It's not that, of course, it is taking time, but right, that doesn't mean that it will not be completed ever. It
in fact, in a previous discussion between Prabhakar and I, when we had discussed the Dwarka Expressway, we've got some consumers who said, oh, Magicbricks, you are painting a rosy picture, but it is not happening. We understand that Dwarka Expressway has taken far longer than it should. There are two, three reasons why we give you a cautious optimism right now. One, like Prabhakar said, it has become a national highway, and the National Highway Authority of India is mandated by the government to be able to sort out problems, resolve disputes and take it forward. Therefore, it's getting a better chance.
And they're in a better way to do it, because once they have advertised and once they have notified an area or land to be acquired by National Highway, then the chances to go into litigation is low.
Yeah.
So it has been done with a view that it should be completed, and it will be completed.
Stakes are very high.
Yeah.
The amount of money that has been spent, Prabhakar, can you estimate?
60,000 crore.
60,000 crore has been invested in the Dwarka Expressway. The government is fully aware of it. There are a lot of issues. We feel that a large number of issues have been resolved. How much is left now of the Dwarka Expressway?
1.1 kilometer.
It is just the last 1.1 kilometer that is causing so much agony to so many people. And we understand the pain of consumers they write agitated notes to us. But we still feel that it has a better chance of early resolution because the National Highway Authority has taken it over now.
And it will reduce the load on the NH8 right now, the traffic congestion and all that. It is going to help a lot in this entire area. But unfortunately, it is hanging
fire. It is hanging fire, and a lot of investment is hanging fire.
Yeah.
As has been happening in the last 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
What are the key things I must keep in mind while buying a resale property, Prabhakar?
Key thing is this. First of all, you must look, if you're buying the secondary market, if I'm a seller, individual seller, then you must ensure that he is a genuine seller. And you should talk to the developer also, that whether he is the buyer or not, what is his registry says.
Yeah.
And then after you look...
Do developers share that information with potential buyers?
Yeah, yeah. Obviously.
So go to the developer and check out that this person who's selling is indeed the person whose name it is registered.
Registered in his registry.
Yeah.
And then after you see the property, whether it has been completed or not, or the possession has already been given, or it is about to be given, all those things she must ensure. And then after, you go to the bank. Now, earlier we used to think that you take loan and the bank will ensure that the genuineness of the property. But of late, we have realized that this is not working.
Banks are not doing enough due diligence.
Yeah.
And therefore, you have to
do the due diligence yourself. And then, of course, go to the bank and take the loan. And let the bank also do the due diligence and go by the bank advice also. But bank will only talk about the project which are ongoing, not completed, that whether this developer is going to complete it or not, or what is the track record and whether they are willing to give the loan on that or not. But about the buyer, you will have to take the due diligence, seller, that whether that seller is genuine or not.
Right.
But for that, then you should go to the developer and see in their register that whether he is the genuine seller or not.
Right. And it's good to spend a little bit and do your own due diligence. You're spending such a large sum of your own money. Spend a little bit, a small percentage, and get a legal opinion. It's good for you.
Yeah.
There is a seller who says she's got an independent house in one of the old sectors of Noida and want to sell. Is this the right time to do so?
This is not the right time to sell the property unless you want to either upgrade or you want to exit because of some other reason. Otherwise, this is not the market to sell the property.
Prabhakar, do you think that the plotted development market in Noida will rise in the future?
Certainly.
You do?
Yeah.
There is a lot of stock in the market as far as new apartments are concerned. And when we look at the profile of demand, we see that the demand profile has shifted towards apartments and gated communities rather than in plotted areas. So when we advise this seller, should we, feel that you should continue to look for buyers. You may get a much lower rate today. That's the risk you run.
Yeah.
But will the rates go up?
Now look, two, three things now here. Now, if those villa or those bungalows are inside the gated community, then prices is bound to go up.
Right.
If it is not inside the gated community, now if it is an open area, then find out that whether there is a resident welfare association who are planning to do it, or is it in the offing. Now, if it is not gated community, then prices to go up is not that easy, because security is a huge issue in Noida, Greater Noida, Gurgaon, in all these areas. So then you should not buy in those areas. But if it is a gated community, the prices is going, look to sector 15A.
Yeah.
I mean the 14, the way the price is going up only, it never goes down.
Right.
So there are other areas also which is gated one. So the prices there are going up. So if you are going to buy the bungalows also, you must ensure that you are buying in a gated community area, not in an open area. And particularly when authority says it is in, remains open area.
Right.
And there the prices appreciation is very slow, because till the residents themselves forms an associations and create a gated community and ask the authority to build a wall, and then after they put the chowkidar and all that. Prices don't go up, number one. Number two, the other facilities they don't provide. The in a gated community, what happens that other facilities like the clubhouse or the other facilities are also there. And those facilities are very important.
Right.
So if you are buying a villa, you buy inside a gated community. Don't buy in open villa.
Right.
Prices are not likely to go up.
We have an interesting question here. Will the Indirapuram market become good for buyers, or should they go across and check out Crossings Republic and all, which is lower priced? How do you read the Indirapuram market?
Now look again, two, three things. Now with the widening of NH24, now approach to Crossings Republic will also become very good.
Right.
Okay. Now Crossing Republic, there is some other routes have also been built so that you can come via Noida extension also, and then to the Greater Noida. And Indirapuram, now it all depends on the price differentials. Now today Indirapuram is quoting at 4,500 rupees, okay, or 4,800 rupees. Some of the apartments are quoting even higher, 5,500, 6,000 rupees also. There are good apartments. But what will I say, that it all depends. The prices of Crossings Republics are going to appreciate very fast.
Uh-huh.
Because the day this road become operational, the driving time will reduce.
Yeah. And the work is going on very fast.
Very fast. It will be completed in 2018.
Okay.
I mean, that is what the minister has said. And he's, working with that intention only. So if that is done, then the appreciation will be very fast in Indirapuram, this Vasundhara enclave, rather than in Indirapuram. But distance-wise, it still remains, Indirapuram much closer to Delhi and the Noida, whereas Crossings Republic. So the price differential will remain. But from today, now say it is quoting say 6,000 rupees a flat if you are going to buy it in Indirapuram, and there you will buy at 3,500 or 4,000 rupees. So I believe this 4,000 rupees much better to buy, because that 4,000 rupees will become 6,000 rupees very fast.
Mm-hmm.
Then this 6,000 rupees becoming 9,000 rupees or 8,000 rupees is not that fast. So
the differential will reduce.
Yeah, reduce.
But you're still going to find Indirapuram as a more conveniently located
property
than Crossings, which is a little further away.
We're
going to get into our last couple of questions. There's Mona Singh from Delhi who says, what are the documents one needs to check before buying a resale property?
Documents that, the papers, if it is registered property.
Right.
then he'll have to find out the registry of the papers and the document transfer deeds from the developers and all that papers. Yeah. All the papers.
You should also check that all the water and power and local taxes are all up to date. Otherwise, once you buy the property, you'll be saddled with pending dues. But these are the title documents, the transfer deeds, the sale agreement. These are some of the papers that you have to check. Also, water charges, power charges, municipal taxes, property taxes, have they been paid? Otherwise, you will be stuck with
the best way to go do this, that take loan from the bank. That always everybody says nowadays, right, that take a small amount of loan so that the bank checks all these papers. At least bank do that properly, and then you know it that whether it is. Otherwise, you'll have to find the genuineness of all those properties. You should go to the registry office, you should go to the all other offices to find out that what the paper they have given are genuine or not. Because, or if it is a society, now suppose, then you should have a certificate, the membership certificate also. All those papers you must have in your hand before buying.
Interesting question here from Nand Kishore of Jammu. Is there any body like RERA for sold out societies as well? Who should we approach for our taxes and other issues? I don't think RERA has addressed properties of resale, secondary market and resale market.
No.
Today, the biggest problem that the Indian market faced was that the primary market was not delivering. And I think that is addressing that was the biggest challenge that the government of India had. I think at some point in the future, we may see that the rest of the market will be regulated as well.
Society is the society office, no, normally, mm-hmm. and the registrar of society. They basically look after if there is any complaint. One can go and do a complaint there, or otherwise the consumer court. You can file a case in the consumer court. Those are the only.
And consumer courts are not as difficult or tedious as the regular civil courts.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for joining us. Thanks, Prabhakar, for joining us.
My pleasure.
We will shortly be in our next discussion. We'll be talking about plotted properties across the country. Plotted properties. What is the what are the mechanisms of doing so, and how whether you should buy today, whether you should sell today, what are the rules and regulations for buying plotted property? Do come back and join us next Thursday, same time. Thank you.